We return to the Yogi Inn, and our pink palace now seems to have changed. Inside, we notice elaborate mirrored and patterned tiles on the walls and erotic statues. The sun comes in through the colored glass, twinkling on the mirrored diamond shapes. In the reception hall, there is a roof design resembling a peacock, giving off iridescent sparkles of blue and turquoise green. In vases, there are peacock feathers. Shakti takes one out and starts to circle me with one. I do the same to her. Through a garden and courtyard decorated with beautiful fountains, with even more erotic statues and pomegranate trees, we feather each other. We continue spinning and laughing past incredible latticework and ornamented pillars along a grand staircase into our room. It is filled with more mirrored colored glass, opening to a view of a lake. We turn each other around very slowly. Our postures and movements become more attuned to each other in an increasingly heightened awareness of our own and each other's bodily rhythms. Shakti opens her lotus-shaped eyes with a twinkle as she unveils her sari to reveal draped there the red ruby and diamond necklace from the exhibition, outlining the shapeliness of her bare breast. From her luscious hips, I gingerly dispatch her skirt's upper hem, and she, the same, to my bejeweled dressing gown. I am in the royal palace of her beauty, her splendor. There is a fragrant perfection to our bodies as we press closer, entwined in this moment, sexual, mystical, and architectural. One overlay, another in mutually illuminating glosses. In the embrace of my beloved, I forget the whole world, everything both within and without. In the same way, she who embraces the self knows neither within nor without. From these lofty heights of metaphoric fancy, we descend to earthliness. She caresses my bare back, still red from the stings of her blow. Embracing, kissing, scratching, biting, moaning, our limbs entwined, making love. Delirious with each other, we are an erotic poetry, finding ever new erotic delights. We copulate squatting, standing, intertwined, with head and foot reversed. We copulate. I performing the temporality of death and vanishing, and her, the great goddess, performing the archetype of endurance. I perish into her eternity, into her erotic power. I give her the milk of cream, and her breasts give me the milk of lactation. Milk and cream, butter and cheese, semen and milk, all are involved in this celebration of sexuality. In the mirror now, in repose, we appear as an ancient fertility statue, the male genitalia implicit in the fecund body of the great mother. We take on this very dimorphic quality, being both male and female, a unity. Together, we are one and the same, the aspect of continuity and the sharp crispness of individuation and vanishing time. What philosophy, secularized and conceptualized as the first cosmology, the cosmology at the dawn of time of the first universal religion, eroticism and love.